Today, I'm going to present you a brand new 3D printer created from scratch here at Architects3DP. If you are not new in the channel,
you may already know our Architects3DP i3, a cheap but good quality 3D printer that we built from scratch in a complete series here at Architects3DP. It was inspired by the original Prusa i3 from Joseph Prusa.
But using cheaper components and some of the 3D printed parts from the original Prusa i3 MK2S, always trying to keep its price under the $200 mark. By the way, if you don't know this project yet, I strongly recommend you to check it out clicking in the link in the description. And also subscribe to Architects3DP to discover the new projects that are coming to the channel.
The Architects3DP i3 had a print volume of approximately 250 by 240 by 200 millimeters.
What is the standard size that you can find in most of the 3D printers in the market? But this time we're gonna build the Architects3DP MEGA. And yes, I decided to name it MEGA regarding to its huge size. Once built,
it will have a print volume of 1000 by 500 by 700 mm and an external size of 1200 by 700 by 800 mm. What is insane?
I could literally print myself at real scale in one piece. As you can imagine,
there are not many printers with this size in the market,
so it's gonna be something unique. And like we did with the Architects3DP i3,
where we use some of the 3D printed parts designed by the Prusa team, this time I'm designing each of the 3D printed components from scratch, which entails the elaboration of many prototypes until I get the perfect version.
As always, if you're a Patreon supporter,
you'll get access to all the STL as well as Rhino files of the project, so you can print the necessary components
to build your own Architects3DP MEGA. If you still haven't, you can become a Patreon supporter navigating to patreon.com/Architects3DP or clicking in the link in the description.
The design of the Architects3DP MEGA is not finished yet, since I'll be developing it together with you along this complete series.
For now, I've only finished the design of some of the components
that you will see in the coming episode of this series, and you will be able to download from our Patreon blog once the episode is published.
By the way, I don't have a closed number of episodes as we did in the Architects3DP i3,
since this one is gonna be much more complex.
And I don't really know yet how many episodes will be necessary for this build, but trust me, we're gonna be able to build it until the end. However,
I've summarized the structure of the build that we're gonna follow along this series. I'll probably need to make more than one episode for some of the points in this list, but in theory, this is gonna be the chronological order of the build.
So as you can see, this is the project presentation.
And next, we're gonna go with the structure of the printer. First the design and unboxing, then the structure assembly, then we'll assemble the extruders, the x-axis structure and movement, the y-axis structure and movement, the z-axis structure and movement, the installation of the power supply, the electronics assembly, the LCD assembly, the cooling configuration, the heated bed installation, some firmware configuration, and finally the software configuration.
We used cheap components and clones to build the Architects3DP i3
to be able to keep it under the $200 mark.
This time, as you can imagine, you won't be able to build this beast 3D printer for only 200 bucks.
But it won't cost you $20,000 or similar prices that industrial sized 3D printer cost.
Instead, you'll be able to build it
with premium components from the best brands in the industry and keep its total price lower than the price of, for example, an Ultimaker 3. Being its print volume 38 times the print volume of the Ultimaker 3, which is crazy.
By the way, regarding these best quality components I was talking before, this project is gonna be possible here at Architects3DP thanks to the collaboration of some of the best companies
in the world of 3D printing and CNC machining.
These companies are going to sponsor this video by providing the components to build the best Architects3DP MEGA possible. And I wanna make clear that these companies did not pay me to say that their components are the best.
Instead, I simply chose their components for the design simply because I think are the best fit for my project.
To have an idea of the companies that we are talking about, let's check out this great sponsors board.
First, Damen CNC, a company based in the Netherlands, provided most of the components for the linear movement of every axis. Trust me that they made a crazy sponsoring, and I wanna thank them for that. Next sponsor, Synerges, a company based in Spain, provided all the components for the structure. In the extruders, because the MEGA will be a dual extruder printer, we will find some components provided by great companies such as E3D for the hot ends, Montec with their dual gear extruders, and Noctua, that is not only going to cool the extruders, but also the electronics and printing chamber of the printer. All the electronics have been provided by Duet3D, including two boards, a 7-inch touchscreen, and all the necessary sensors for the build. Finally, all the printed parts will be possible thanks to Zacata3D, a filament manufacturer based in Spain that will provide all the necessary PETG filament for the 3D printed components of the Architects3DP MEGA.
There are still some components that could be sponsored for this build, such as the heated bed heating pads, the aluminium plate, the printing surface, or plexiglass panels for the enclosure. If you are a company or you want to be part of this project as well, just let me know through my email, architects3dp@gmail.com. The links to buy all the necessary components used in each of the episodes will be available to buy from the bill of materials that you will find linked on the description of every single episode, and I will update episode by episode with all the necessary components. Alright, so that has been more or less the presentation of this huge project that, as you can see, I'm very excited about. If you have any question or suggestion about this Architects3DP MEGA, please let me know in the comment section. I will love to answer to all of your comments and get any positive idea that could change the design of the Architects3DP MEGA to make it better. In the next video, we're gonna start with the design of the structure.
Based in 40mm aluminium extruded profiles and the unboxing of the components coming from Synerges.
Finally, I just wanted to ask you to subscribe to Architects3DP if you still haven't, hit the like button, leave a comment, and share this video so more people will be able to enjoy with this project. And as always, a special shout out to our Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. If you want to join them and support the channel as well, you can do it navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp, clicking here in the top right corner, or in the link in the description. Remember that becoming a Patreon, you will get access to all the necessary components for this project, as well as all the past projects in the channel, and much more rewards that you can check in our Patreon page. Okay guys, so as always, see you in the next video!